John Raese knows that we can't keep racking up debt, over $13 trillion in debt, and Obama points backwards and blames everybody else, and yet he has perpetuated the problem in these last 2 years. Heck, before that, don't forget, he was a United States senator casting those votes for those big old budgets, and yet he wants to blame everybody else. That doesn't fly in West Virginia. Y'all are smarter than that. Now, John Raese knows that our country can no longer afford porked-out budgets full of sweetheart appropriations. We do need smaller, smarter government, and the only way to get that is to change the leadership in Washington. The leadership in D.C. must change, and it must start listening to we, the people. The left's agenda will not get us there. Washington's agenda must change. We can't afford politicians who will rubber stamp their party's agenda. We need real leaders like John Raese. West Virginia and America cannot afford what's coming down the pike if we don't turn this car around. You know what's coming? Cap and tax. Obama likes to call it cap and trade, but what it is a job-killing piece of legislation that will affect every single one of you, every aspect of our economy. We cannot allow this to go through, but that's what we're going to get if you have a rubber stamp in there for Obama, who is representing the state. It is all the more reason, West Virginia, in these final hours, you need to be getting out there, getting the vote out, making sure that your neighbors, that your friends, that your families understand that it is imperative that cap and tax not be allowed to go through. It will decimate our economy. It will make us more beholden to foreign countries as we rely on them to produce energy for us. It will outsource our jobs, those jobs that you are waiting for, those jobs that you deserve, because these are American resources that are God-given. They are provided for us to responsibly develop and use for mankind.